A common question we get asked is, you know, why would I do a postgraduate program in cloud computing? Why do I have to do this rigorous program? Isn't a certification enough? I've put a little snapshot or a screenshot from one of the companies, a VP at one of the companies whose sentiment is echoed by a number of employers. We've spoken to a number of industry experts and senior advisors for our program. If you wanted to be an architect, if you want to be a solution architect, and you don't come with the requisite background, and you haven't spent years and years honing your craft, it's very hard for a simple certification to change how people perceive you, how people evaluate you when you're going to try and get either a job elsewhere or a role within your own organization. And the only way to do that is to learn by doing. One of the reasons a more rigorous program is suitable is because it gives you more opportunities to do more hands-on work. Certifications are very valuable. They get your foot in the door because they get caught by the right people, by the right filters. The HR filters, the automated job filters will always catch your certification listed in your resume or in your profile. But then your experience takes over. As a mid-career professional, I'm not just going to trust that, hey, you have an AWS certification, therefore I'll give you a job that's worth lakhs and lakhs of rupees and where you will be in a position of responsibility managing dozens of engineers or more. That's not how it works at the mid-career level. So at the very, very early level, I think a certification is increasingly valuable. At the mid-career level, I think it's table stakes. It's not going to truly differentiate you, but it is absolutely necessary if you want to move into this area. And I think it's something that will happen over time with very little effort if you've gone through something much more rigorous like this program. Mid-career jobs require more than one skill. It's something that you saw in that graph I showed you earlier about all the different skills, the skills in demand, and so on. Right? If you want to be a mid-career, if you want to move into this area as a mid-career professional, people expect a lot of you. People don't just expect that you know how to configure a system, do you know how to do system operations, that you know how to, you know, manage and load balance a couple of systems. What they really want is to see is the ability to solve problems, to think through practical issues, to build solutions, and that is a multidisciplinary effort, right? That really, really comes again with hands-on practice, with a little bit of ruminating, with looking at it from different perspectives, and understanding how different perspectives work, how different functions work, rather. And finally, the one thing you do want to learn, and we emphasize, is how things actually work, not how they're supposed to work. Again, if you go through a very standard script of this is how a system needs to be configured, yeah, sure, it makes sense. How many of you have tried to take a fairly complicated manual, or in the early days tried to install Linux on your computer, and instead of taking an hour like a video or a manual would tell you, you would actually take a week or a month. That's what happens in practice. With lots of practice over time, you start to develop an intuitive understanding of what works and what doesn't, and more importantly, why it works. And you'll start to see patterns, and you start to develop an understanding of, you know, which elements go together, which elements don't make sense, you know, which services can be used together, what are the pitfalls of using something. This is valuable expertise. And this is exactly what companies pay for. This is why they hire solutions architects. This is why they hire people at a premium. Now, I'm not saying that all of this will happen through one postgraduate program either. A certification certainly isn't enough. A postgraduate program is also not necessarily enough, but it gets you a lot further than a basic certification. On top of this, on top of all the hands-on work you'll be doing in the program, you really, really need to have a very inquisitive mind. You need to develop the ability, if you don't already have it, to start to question, you know, various assumptions about how things work, and build the ability to, you know, to start to see patterns and trends and indications of trouble, you know, the ability to troubleshoot. That is really what will differentiate you in this kind of marketplace. And that really, from a mid-career professional perspective, that is really what will, you know, bring you the big bucks. That's what commands a premium in the market, and that's also what gives you the the kind of the really juiciest roles where you're making these really challenging calls, having taken all the trade-offs into account. You can't really do that if you don't understand, you know, if you can't empathize with the developer on the team, if you can't empathize with the DevOps team, if you can't empathize with you know, the network challenges, the system challenges, and so on. So you really need to look at it more holistically than just one narrow function and say, okay, how do all these different things work? And only then can I make a choice about which system to use, which service to use, how often to use it, how do I get them to integrate with each other, which one should connect to which one, what should my billing system be, and so on.